Hello, massage nurse. Today I'm going to be doing a video on how to interview a client, on tips on how to interview a client. And it was one of my students that asked me, so this one's for you, Miguel. To me, the most important question that you ask a client, you know, when you first start interviewing them is, have you ever had a massage before? Because that way it'll tell you how much time you're going to need to spend doing a little bit more explanation. So once I get that out of the way, then I know, okay, so instead of having, if they've had a massage before, then I only need 3 minutes to explain things to them. But if they've never had a massage before, then I'm going to need a little bit of extra time. And that's another thing that it differs. If you're self-employed, like, you know, I've been for 33 years, I can usually set, you know, half an hour in between my clients, 15 minutes for the interview. But if you work for a chain or a spa, or, you know, you work for somebody else, you might not have that luxury. So make sure that your questions are precise. It's best not to ask open-ended questions. Like, don't say, does your back hurt? Once they tell you, you know, their back hurts, does your back hurt? Say, can you tell me more about where you feel the pain? Ask them more elaborate questions where they have to give you an explanation, so that way you can find out more. And you always want to do some reflective listening. Reflective listening is really very important, especially for those of you that work for somebody else. And I'll explain to you why. Because you can always document that you ask your client. Let's say somebody comes in and they tell you, my shoulder hurts. And you go, tell me more about your shoulder hurting. You go, well, they tell you, well, it hurts when I shampoo my hair. And then you reflective listening to them will be, oh, so let me understand this. If I understand this correctly, every time you raise your arm to shampoo or to do anything that extends your arm, it hurts. And then they agree. And then you say, okay, would you like for me to spend 10 minutes extra on your shoulder and take away maybe from another area? And if they agree and say yes, then you document that. Because I've had students let me know that clients complained that they didn't give them a full body massage, or that they didn't spend enough time, you know, somewhere else. But if you were reflective listening to them and giving them back the information where they have to agree with you, not that they have to agree with you, I shouldn't say that, but, you know, where they do agree with you, then you can document that, and you're covering yourself. So it's always important to speak clearly, you know, and straight, so that way you know exactly what you're going to do, and you explain to them what you're going to do, and they're going to agree. And that way, you know, you're more clear on what you're going to do during that 50 minutes. I know some spas or some chains only work 50 minutes, or if it's an hour, if you're a private, you know, and you want to go extra, make sure you clear all that up before your client gets on the table. One of the reasons that I like to start supine is because they're face up and you can see their facial expressions, and they might want to talk a little bit. They might want to interact a little bit more with you. And it's better when, you know, when they're supine than when they're prone. When they're prone, it's difficult to hear what they're saying, and it's difficult for them to talk. So, like I said, that's one of the reasons why I start supine, and because I always like to do the neck and shoulders and relax that area first, and then go to the to the face before you go to the feet. So another thing that you must is ask the client before they lay on the table, do you have any questions? That way you open the door. Like, if it's a first-time client, you know, maybe there's something that you didn't answer for them and they might need to, you know, to ask you now. And it creates that communication, because communication is and trust is so important, especially with returning clients. However, if you work in a spa or in an airport where you're never going to see that client again, you know, I've heard that too. You know, I have a lady from Jamaica that she says, you know, she only sees those clients one time, you know, and that's it. So find out what they want, what they're expecting out of the massage, and then explain to them what you believe how the massage is going to help them. I always tell my clients, realistically, you know, I believe, like if they have an injury, realistically, you know, I believe that you're probably going to need to come back 2 or 3 times before you start feeling better. And, you know, if they're in for a relaxation massage, then, you know, massage should be relaxing. So I suggest, you know, that you kind of tune in and take deep breaths and relax. And, you know, it's like you want to give feedback to your client about what you and how you feel and what you believe in massage can do for them, because you're planting seeds, you know, you're maybe even re-educating, you know, some beliefs that they might have, that maybe you can clear up some of those questions for them. But like I said, always at the end, make sure that you speak clearly and tell them what you're going to do and how you're going to accommodate to better service them. And I also want to talk, like, if you were the client, you know, if you are the client or you know your clients, you know, this happened 20 years ago to me, and it was the best thing I've learned from my clients. I had a couple that had just moved in from Austin to El Paso, and they scheduled 3 massages with 3 different massage therapists. And when they came in with me, they told me, you know, we're interviewing a massage therapist and we want to pick the best one because you're going to be part of our budget. You know, we're going to put aside every month to come see you. And like I said, it was a couple. So it was, you know, it's an expense. She says, you know, this is part of our expense for, you know, going to the, for our budget to go to the dentist or the optometrist or, you know, whatever health appointments they may have, chiropractor. So to me, it's so important for clients to interview different massage therapists. There is nothing wrong with that. You know, clients should be knowing more about you, especially if it's going to be a long-term relationship. They should be able to interview different massage therapists. And you should go with somebody you feel comfortable with, somebody you connect with. And, you know, some clients like to talk a lot, some clients don't. And as a therapist, you must stay, you know, within the comfort level of the client. You know, don't promote any talking. Once they're, you know, to the contrary, promote them being quiet so they can go within. So anyway, I could go on talking forever about this. So I just wanted to give you these tips. Again, you know, first question, have you ever had a massage before? And then do the medical history and then do the interview. Always reiterate, you know, reflective listen, you know, that you were listening to what their needs are. And then at the end, right before they get on the table, tell them, you know, are you okay with me doing X, Y, and Z? And ask them, do you have any questions? Do you have any questions for me? So I hope this helps. Till the next time, create a great day.